I'm Kensani Maranele with this news update. Over 20 drunken drivers arrested in Johannesburg. Heavy rains cause road closures in KwaZulu-Natal. Over 20 drunken drivers were arrested on Johannesburg roads over the past 12 hours at various roadblocks. The number of arrests for traffic infringements peaked to over 1,000 this week. The Johannesburg Metro Police have vowed to clamp down on any unlawful behavior on the city's roads during the festive period. They've also recorded less traffic on roads leaving the city. As Metro Police spokesperson Wayne Minar explains,
all of the drivers had to pay bail of between 1,000 rand and 1,500 rand after their blood samples were taken. And then the drivers were placed in police cells. There will be some more roadblocks today and tomorrow, and motorists are encouraged to obey the rules of the road and not to drink and drive. The traffic flow is eased down as much of the traffic left Joburg last night.
The R102 bridge near Umgababa on the KwaZulu-Natal south coast has been closed due to damage caused by last night's heavy rain. KwaZulu-Natal Department of Transport spokesperson Gwanele Ngalane says vehicles are directed to the N2 freeway.
Well, we want to warn motorists who are using R102 driving from Durban to the south in the area of Umgababa that opposite Caridino Hotel. There has been a destruction on the bridge there, and that has led to us to close the bridge. Therefore, the traffic is closed there for now, and we do have our traffic officers who are controlling the scene, and we are urging all motorists to divert to N2 the freeway. We are positive that yesterday's weather and heavy rainfall contributed to the damage that was caused in the bridge.
Three vehicles have been swept away by heavy rain on the road between Makupane and Marken in Limpopo. Police spokesperson Hangwani Malawuzi says the vehicles were trying to cross the bridge unawares that it had collapsed. The occupants of all three vehicles are reported to have escaped unhurt. The road has been closed for traffic and motorists are advised to use alternative routes.